Assalamu alaikum and hello to everyone to today's lecture video about signal storage in electro-pneumatics. So what do we mean by signal storage? Signal storage is actually the ability of the system to remain in the same state after a change was performed. So in the case of a pneumatic actuator, if there is a signal to extend the piston, then the piston remains in the extension state until a new signal is sent, and this is what we mean by this statement. So to go to a new state, a new change is required, which is also a new signal is required. And to achieve signal storage, we could do it either mechanically or electrically. And there are many methods, however we are only going to look at four of them. So the first one being memory valve, also called double solenoid valve. Second is mechanical latch button, electrical latch circuit, and fourthly latch relay. In the case of a latch circuit, there is further classification. So we have two types of electrical latch circuits known as dominant on, dominant off. We are going to look into this further in the coming slides. Let us look at the first method first, where we have double solenoid valve and two push buttons. So double solenoid valve is a must. This is what makes the signal storage. And it doesn't matter whether it is a single acting cylinder or double acting cylinder. So once this solenoid is energized, the DCV will be in the left switching position, and once this solenoid is energized, the DCV will be in the left switching position, and it maintains that position until the next signal is sent. So how to achieve that using the electrical circuit? We need to have a push button for the solenoid and another push button for the second solenoid. Let us look at the mechanical latch button. In this case, we only implement a single solenoid and there is no second solenoid. And that what makes the set button different from the previous example. The electrical circuit is quite simple. We only use single button to energize a single solenoid. Let us look at the third method, which is a latch circuit. Again, we are seeing single solenoids being used and two push buttons, one for the start, one for the off. And what makes a latch circuit is actually the relay that has a contact in open, normally open condition. And this contact of this relay eventually channels the power supply to the relay after the release of this push button. So we need to bear that in mind. This contact is of high importance. And then we have this off button to make the latch circuit break up. And the way we place this off button changes the circuit from dominant off to dominant on. So if the off button is placed here, we call it dominant off, and if the off button is placed here, we call it dominant on. So what is the difference between the two other than the construction of the circuit? Actually, functionally there are differences. When the start button is closed, or the contact of the push button is closed, so the latch circuit is on. But if at the same time the off button is pressed, then the relay will no longer be on. Hence the name is dominant off, meaning when both start and off buttons are pressed, then off is the dominant condition, meaning the relay is no longer in on condition. Whereas in the other case, where we have the off button on the other current line, if the start button is closed and the relay is on, and meanwhile somebody is pressing the off button, does that make the relay off? No. Why? Because the line between the start button and the relay is clear. Whereas here, the line is interrupted by the off button. So the off button takes over. Hence, dominant off. Whereas here, dominant on. Because when on is closed, even if somebody presses the off button, the relay still is in on condition. Okay, let us look at the fourth type of latch relay. Let us look at the fourth type of the signal storage method, which is the latch relay. So what is a latch relay? Latch relay is an interesting component where we have a relay with dual coils. One coil is shown in figure, and this is the second coil. So what happens is, when a push button is connected to the first coil and a second push button is connected to the second coil, this causes the relay to have two states, either in the normally closed or in the other way, depending on which push button is operated. So for example, if somebody presses this button, which causes coil 1 to be on, so the terminal 1 will be connected to terminal 2. However, if somebody presses this button, which energizes coil 2, then terminal 1 will be connected to terminal 4. Terminal 1 will be connected to terminal 4. So this is what we call latch relay. Other names of it, or to be more specific, other technologies include magnetic latching relay, mechanical latching relay, and even impulse latching relays. So this is the circuit of a latching relay, where we have the latching relay and two push buttons, and then the contact of the relay is connected to the output, or for that sake it could be anything else, like a lamp or a buzzer or even just another relay. So we have two push buttons and a latching relay. Again, we are seeing single solenoid DCV. We are not using double solenoid. So I would like you to find out what happens if both push buttons are operated at once. Which coil is going to be energized? So I leave that for you to find out. This is an overview of all the discussed methods, where three of them, this is dominant off, dominant on, the mechanical latch button, and also the latch relay. All of these circuits rely on the single solenoid DCV, whereas the double solenoid valve uses two push buttons. Okay, here's an important distinction that we want to make between signal storage and continuous cycle. Signal storage is what we have seen earlier, how to keep the state of the pneumatic piston in one state only, to be either in extension or retraction. However, continuous cycle refers to keeping the whole circuit running continuously. So if you have a piston, it could be in the reciprocating or oscillating or cyclic motion. So it goes in extension and then retracts, extension, retracts, and keeps doing that for as long as the circuit is in continuous cycle. How to do continuous cycle? Here we have presented almost 6 examples. Not to say that these are the only examples, rather there could be other examples. However, I'm going to highlight the first example and the 6th example in the next slide. So what is the first? Using a latch button with a double solenoid valve, and the 6th one using a latch circuit twice. So we have 2 or double latch circuits with single solenoid valve. So this is the first example on the left side, where we have a latch button, set button, used with double solenoid valve. And the second one is using double latch circuits. So the first latch circuit, second latch circuit with a single solenoid. So these two circuits represent a cyclic or oscillating or the automatic forward and return stroke control. There are many names. So what happens is, when the set button is closed, the piston will be engaging in back and forth motion for as long as the set button is closed. And likewise, on the right side, we have similar function but with different approach, using double latch circuits. Looks quite complicated, but it does the same job, where we have a piston, and once the system is started, that piston will be engaged in oscillating motion back and forth for as long as the off button is not pressed. So this is the off button, this is the start button. So you can start and just release the push button, and don't push the off button so long you want the system to be running, and once you want to stop it, just push the off button. And the second latch circuit is actually the one that achieves the back and forth motion. Remember, we don't have second solenoid, so we are replacing the function of the solenoid with this addition. So this what makes this circuit much more complex in comparison to the example one. So I hope that this lecture was of benefit to you, and hope to see you again.